every now and again we get some funnies who want to have a little bit of a go at Google. And they say, well, hey, if Google have access to all my data, then doesn't that mean that they own my data? And they pull up some weird obscure line in the Google user agreement and, you know, they say, Google's owning your data, Google's an evil company, blah, 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 blah. The reality is that Google does not give a shit about your data, just to be completely honest. All Google cares about is the aggregate behaviors, and this might be scarier for you, but the aggregate behaviors of millions of people, and they use that data to improve their products. Now, your business products that you have with Google, if you're a subscriber to Google Workspace, are not used for advertising. I'm just going to clarify that. Your data and your behaviors inside Google's business tools are not used to advertise to you. If you use the free edition of Gmail, which is a consumer product, which you don't pay for, they do advertise to you in that product, but there's a misconception that Google's business tools either own your data or will be used for advertising, and that's completely false. So it's completely okay as long as you're okay with Google as a company, and that's a different story. But it's completely okay to trust someone like Google and therefore trust the cloud with your data. So the next part of the conversation is then, well, why? Why would we use cloud storage? And I want to go a little bit deeper into the why and why this is so important. Now, most of us probably have a few files lying around on an old hard drive, or maybe they're sitting on our desktop computer. And for many of us, our desktop looks something like this. Not me, I'm a complete neat freak, but I absolutely understand it. And so for those that have data, you know, a little bit of data kind of floating around, or maybe you've got some data sitting on a contractor's computer, or maybe you've got some data sitting on your virtual assistant's computer if you've got an international team member helping you out in the business. Now, what can happen is that businesses can lose data when you have what we in the industry call a data loss event, right? And that's basically something going wrong, you lose data. Now, most businesses do not recover from a large data loss event. And I'm talking about if you lost a year's worth of data or a couple of years worth of data. Most businesses do not recover from that. There is cyber insurance and there's ways of protecting yourself financially from that, but the actual business quite often does not actually survive. And my story around data loss is that I am an avid collector of music. I'm a pretty big music fan. And when I was a teenager, I spent years and years and years collecting music. Now, at the time, I was downloading illegally. Don't shoot me for that. But what I had was this massive library of, I think, about 50 or 60 gigabytes of music, all neatly organized on my computer. And unfortunately, I only had it stored on a single hard drive. And you all know where this is going. It was a single external hard drive. And something happened to the drive. I dropped it, or I erased over it, or something happened, and the data was toast. And I basically lost all of that data. Now, my mistake was I only had the data in one place. And data is not safe unless it's in at least two geographically dispersed locations, right? So data is not safe unless it's in at least two geographically displaced locations. Now, you might say, okay, Pete, well, I've got data sitting on a backup USB hard drive and I send that to my mum's place, right? And if it's only existing in that one place, that data's not actually safe. I think we've all got to the point where now where we know that USB sticks can be dropped, hard drives can get corrupted. Even if you burnt something to a CD, I don't think people do that anymore. They actually have a lifespan where they will deteriorate. Physical media will deteriorate. But what's more likely to happen is something like this, a ransomware attack. What's most likely to happen if you're working on a local computer, a Windows or a Mac machine, Chromebooks are thankfully immune to this, but if you're on a Windows or a Mac machine, from time to time, around comes the crypto locker virus. And these are still out there and all over the place. And this is called ransomware because someone asks you a ransom to pay for you to be able to unlock your data. Now, we had a client of ours who were a law firm and had 30 employees, and they had all of their data sitting on their server, right? And they thought they were safe. Now, they had a backup connected to the server as well. They thought they were safe. But unfortunately, because they had not backed the data up to another geographical location, the ransomware infected the server system, infected all of the desktops, infected the backups, and they were down for literally weeks while it was recovered. Now, they had to pay thousands of dollars in ransom. You know, obviously that was a small price to pay compared to the actual business loss that they had. But we had offered to that customer a cloud backup for their Google Workspace. They had opted not to take that. And unfortunately, they didn't get access. They lost access to their data for a number of weeks. We were able to get 99% of the data back for them, which was very lucky, but not before it stopped their business for a number of weeks, literally in its tracks. Staff went home and sat at home doing nothing because they just didn't have anything else to do. And so I'll cover back up a little bit later when I cover more about Google Drive. But don't think just because you've got Dropbox or just because you've got Google Drive that you're completely safe from a ransomware or a crypto locker attack. What can happen is when your files are infected on your computer, it then synchronizes the infected files to either Dropbox or Google Drive. And so you need to do what's called a point in time restore on those. And that actually takes time and considerable effort to get that to happen. But it's an absolute no-no to be running without a backup online of your files. So previously, when I was using just local storage, and a long time ago I was using Outlook, I ran into the problem where Outlook, after a number of years, starts to run slowly. And I wanted to share with you a couple of tricks in Gmail for any of those who may be in our audience who are still using Outlook. I want to share with you a couple of tricks that you can do inside of Gmail which just completely blow the Microsoft system out of the water. Now, in general, using cloud-based tools and cloud-based technologies and using a browser-based tool is going to be a bit like driving that Tesla. It's much simpler, there's less things that can go wrong, and what it actually means is that because it's running in the browser, you're always running the latest version. Now, with something like Microsoft Outlook, you've got to wait for the latest version to download from time to time, and there's upgrades and there's maintenance, and if something goes wrong, you've got to uninstall it and reinstall it, and all those kind of things exist with Microsoft because it's an app that you install on your computer rather than a website which is available 24/7 for millions and millions of people. Now, when I'm inside my Gmail, I have access to every single one of my emails going back basically to the start of time when I started the business about 12 years ago, nearly 500,000 emails, and the total storage in my mailbox is about 50 gigabytes. Now, inside my mailbox here in my Gmail, I can actually search for an email way back to, let's go back to emails from 2011, and bang, it's immediately going to show me those emails and pop up here with my search request. And so anytime I need to search for an email, doesn't matter how far back I need to go, it's instantly opening up all of my emails. And you just can't do that with Outlook because you've got to auto archive and the PST files get too big and the index on the search starts slowing down. The other thing that I really love about Google is there is an amazing advanced search as well. So if I want to look for an email, maybe to or from Angel, I'll put in Angel's name here. Maybe the subject was Cebu conference. I know we had a conference a number of years ago in Cebu. And from there, let's say it includes the word invoice. I'm just throwing some random bits and pieces here. Oh no, I don't think there was anything to do with an invoice there. Okay, let's try again. Oh no, I think Angel was employed after our Cebu conference. There we go. All right, let's try invoice again. And that's gonna bring it up. Now, you can see here that out of the 500,000 emails in my inbox, four emails between Angel and myself include the word invoice. And so this is something called search stacking, where we all use google.com, and we all know a few tricks with google.com, right? You can put quotation marks around what you're trying to search for, and that will help you find an exact string. Inside of Gmail, you have a search that is just as powerful as Google's full web search and allows you to find anything you need inside your emails. Now, are you ready for me to fry your noodle? Let me fry your noodle here. If the search is this powerful, why would you ever bother using folders? There's just no use to bother using folders if you can always find exactly what you need by searching. And so, storing all of your files online, not only will it keep you safe from losing your computer, breaking your computer, crypto locker, viruses, all kinds of things that can go wrong, not only does it help with the productivity of your team, but using cloud-based email like Gmail might just save you 20 or 30 minutes a day that you spend right now either filing or having trouble finding information. And many people are just in complete inbox overwhelm. I get that. Not everyone's even got the time to file anymore. Most of us just like kind of leave it in complete abdication. That's totally fine. I understand that. But what we have with Google is the ability to find and retrieve information in a simple way, and that makes our life a lot easier.